Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Ma, I live in UK, and this is a channel about semi-hydroponics and houseplants in semi-hydroponics, houseplants in LECA, however you want to call it. Right, so because sorry for that, I should put my phone on silent. Right, so because I've put on my Instagram like a poll with what do you want to see in my next video, and most of you wanted to see the watering process, I'll make a video about this. So, what I want to tell you, don't follow any rules. So, don't do something because someone is telling you that that thing is working for them. Okay? That's why I keep telling everyone, watch your plant. Notice what your plant wants. If she's happy with 1/3 of the reservoir or half a reservoir of water, give it to her. If she's happy with no water in the reservoir, don't give it. I sound fucking smart, am I? Right. I will show you. I know some of you are measuring the water, well, I hope you are, with the TDS or the EC. I prefer EC, but I will show you how much TDS and how much EC is the same thing. They are measuring the total dissolved solids in the water, so the nutrients in the water, both of them, but they are different units of measure, right? So let's see first the TDS of my water, because I have the watering can here with the water. The ppm, the ppm, it's 91. I hope you can see it. Can you see it? Yeah, it's 91. So this is the TDS. I'm always measuring after EC. I don't know why. What I'm doing here, EC. So my EC in the water, I think it's, there is a formula, but I don't. So my EC in the water, I always go, I'm going for the EC, it's 191. So not too much nutrients. My dog is really restless. Everyone is really restless in this house, because my husband is working from home, because that thing that it's ruling our lives at the moment is in his workplace. Ozzy, stop it. He will not stop it. He will be a pain. Look at him. Look at that little thing. You can't even imagine how much trouble he can make. Okay. So, watering can. Plants. Watch your plants. What I've noticed, this one doesn't have so much water because I've watered them a few days ago. So, African violet, Streptocarpus, in my environment, prefers half. If they are flowering, if they have flower, that half will last for 3 days. Not more, not less. 3 days. That's it. After 3 days, I have to put more water. They will suck the water. When they are not flowering, the water, see, I have some algae here as well. Doesn't matter. I picked up the ones that are transparent so I can show you better. So they will tolerate half of reservoir of water. They don't care. They are all water root inside and some algae. But they are all right. So this is what they are tolerating. Half of reservoir of water. They don't have any problems. I don't have any African violets that died. None of them. I love this one with this foliage. A moment. I had a moment. Right. So they will tolerate a lot of water. But what example should I give you? Oh, right. My lupinum, Philodendron lupinum. See, this is a big, I think it's a pint. I don't know, I'm not so good with the measurements. I don't know. I can't see anything. Anyway, it's a big one, right? Do you see the level of the water? Can you see it? It's here. That's it. And I will not put any water because this is a transparent pot, right? You can see that leca till here. So the first layer it's dry, but till here it's wet. So if this reservoir will disappear in a few days and the leca is still wet, I will still not water the plant. I will still not water the plant till when I will see that half of this cup, plastic cup, however they are called, half of this leca is dry, then I will water just a bit, just a tiny bit, just that much, not more, that much. And that will be sufficient for this one. Hoya, I don't have any Hoya and transparent cups, but these are white. With the Hoyas, I'm doing something else. And you know why? Because usually the stem of the Hoya can produce roots along the stem, right? So I will leave, if I can, a long stem that I will put, sorry, I will put till the bottom. Yeah, I will, brain is not working, it's late, brain is not working, excuse me. So I will put a long stem on the bottom of the pot and I will put the leca. This, a small cup, will dry quicker than a bigger one, and makes sense because there is not so much surface to absorb the water. So what do I do with these ones? I'll take this type of bottle with a, I don't know, they are called cactus something, and I will water the plant here, just squirt, just like that. That's it. So I will make sure that I will water where is the stem going in, and that will be it. And this one doesn't have any water anyway. And after that I will watch, because you can see that wet leca leave like an impression on the cup. Okay, so I will watch if I will have wet leca here, but usually it will take me like 1 week. Not now, because I have the central heating on. Now it will take me like 4 days for a cup like that to get dry. Ozzy, please settle down. Something scared him. I don't know what. Probably his shadow. So, every 4 days or something like that, I could just give it just a bit of water there. And it's working fine with all my Hoya so far. Yes, I killed my gray ghost. I know you will tell me that. But I have another one, and Anna told me that she spoke with more collectors of Hoya that told her that Grey Ghost doesn't do well in leca. Well, challenge accepted. Well, it was no challenge actually, but I want to prove to you that Grey Ghost will do great in leca. If not, Anna, sorry, you'll have to send me another one. Okay. What else can I tell you about the watering? Shut up, Ozzy! What else can I tell you about the water? Don't follow any rules, right? Do not follow any rules. Just look at your plants and see how well they are doing. And by the way, if you have... Right, I'll take this dubia. These are two different pots. This is a tubia growing in there. And this is the Cebu Blue from my lovely friend Emily from Washington. Okay. If you take a plant from a small pot and put it on a bigger pot like that, right? Double the size. Do not water this in the same manner that you water this. Why? Because it's a bigger pot, it will hold the water for a longer time. So let's say, for the sake of argument, that you are watering this once a week, You will water this once every 2 weeks or even 3 weeks, depending on your climate. Okay? Because it's bigger, it will hold the water for a longer period of time. And I will give you another example. This is a bigger pot. This is my Florida ghost. Well, excuse her because she was cut a few times. But it's a bigger pot. I think I just put some water once in a while. Let's say maybe once a month. Maybe, if I can remember. Or I would just put around the lake on the top just a bit of this every, don't know, when I remember. But he's fine. He's there. I have it for the last 2 years. He grew up a lot, believe me, but he was chopped a lot because I needed money for my Hoyas. And I need more money, so I put more plants on eBay. Okay, what else I could tell you about watering? Right, if you have a plant that is sitting on a windowsill with the full sun, you might need to water that more often as well. So that's why it's really important just to watch your plants, see what they want, see what they need, and provide for them. And I think that's kind of it, because it will take me like 6 hours to upload this video. So if you have any more questions, please comment down below. And I'll make the best to answer to all of them. And subscribe. And bye-bye.